killers. They were tenacious. They were strong. Now what are we? Passive, lazy, weak.
My brother.
Culture and technology hasn't improved us. It's brought us to our knees. If our ancestors could see us now, they would be ashamed. They would be sickened, and they would be angry. We have forgotten where we came from. We have forgotten who we are. No longer. We will become killers. We will become tenacious. We will become strong. We must look to our past when life was simple and hard. Basic survival. That's when we were at our best. You see, the world has become soft, weak. We have sheltered ourselves from every obstacle, danger, and fear. No longer flush, search for our water and fire. We're no longer hungry, thirsty, or cold. We're no longer alive.
Sacrifice.
You must be hungry. Yeah. Did you know it takes 10 days for civilization to collapse?
Yeah. You take away a man's basic needs, and he will revert to his primordial instincts in just 10 days. That's a difficult thing to understand unless you've lived it. Well, I was in Iraq during the first Gulf War. 82nd Airborne All-Americans, hoorah!
One night there was an ambush. And me and this guy named Miller got separated from the unit. No food, no radio. Nearest base, 200 clicks to the south, so we just started walking. Well, by the third day, I knew we were lost. Day six, ran out of water. You know what that's like, don't you? Difficult to swallow. On the seventh day, Miller's legs started going all wonky. Did you know your brain starts to eat your muscles in order to survive? That's why you're so goddamn skinny. And by the eighth day, the wolves were closing in. And I looked at Miller and I could tell we were as good as dead. And I accepted that. And in that acceptance came clarity. You see, I wasn't just looking at Miller. I was looking at an opportunity. It wasn't something I wanted. It was something that I had to do. It was my test. You see, Miller's sacrifice wasn't about me walking out of that desert. It was about bringing me here. The weak have their purpose. You'll understand that soon enough.
Hero! Wake up. Rocco.
I'm gonna get you out of here, okay? And we're gonna get out of here, okay? Only you. Only you. Hey, what about me? What about me? You aren't strong enough. You have to get out of here before it starts again. Follow me. He knows you're ready to do it. Look. Trials. See? He's got it all planned out. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Then he's got you. It becomes second nature, routine. It gets in your head. And you don't even realize it. You can't ever go back. You understand? You can't ever go back. Come on. Truck. That truck's gotta be there. Gotta get on the truck. It's almost time. I've studied the route for weeks. It's the only way out. You'll be safe if you don't. Not yet! Oh, fuck! Fuck! No! 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 Sorry.
I know you're probably out there trying to get your friend Pratt back, but us Whitetails could still use a hand. Anyways.
Name's Jess.
You know where to find us.
Name's Jess.
That gorilla type fight. We gotta get the resistance somewhere.
Our time is near. This is no accident. This is no surprise. We have been warned throughout history.
Is this the best we can find? Kind of pathetic,
the
really.
The Mongols, the Babylonians, all of them gone. And what have we learned? Empires always crumble. This is our final warning. This is our final collapse. We must prepare for what comes next. We must prepare for the new. Do what needs to be done. Sacrifice. And when the moment finally comes, we will be ready. Mother Nature doesn't care who you are or where you came from. The cautious and empathetic. Only the strong survive.
We'll be right back.
people prisoner there, starving them for Jacob's fucked up conversions. And thanks for springing Jess. You might want to check in with her. She's one of the best whitetails we got.
You sure as hell know how to handle it yourself. The cook's days are numbered.
Peggy's have been busy training at the ranger station. Thought nothing of it until I heard the screaming. Bastards are using the hostages as target practice. I couldn't take them all myself, but with your help, I know I can save them.
Take more than a little love to bring this place back up to spec.
Trail's gonna go cold.
Heard good things.
I hope they're true.
basic survival. That's when we were at our best. You see, the world has become soft. We have sheltered ourselves from every obstacle, danger, and fear. Search for our water or make fire. We're no longer hungry, thirsty, or cold. We're no longer alive. The solution is war. War will bring us life. War will bring us life.
The world has become soft.
Good work, Deputy. That ranger station was a one-stop shop for training cult marksmen. Now the whitetails can take the goods and use the range. You're turning the tide, Dep.
I've been to the Elkjaw Lodge. I've seen what they do to those wolves firsthand. You gotta help me put a stop to this.
Buddy, over here!
Good, some of them bad. judges no longer share the unfiltered, crippling traits of their brethren. No, their desire is still. But the power of authorship exists. Now there's no fight. Only fight. Judges call the herd to stick. The old, the weak, and the unworthy.
Shadow that you've cleared out the elk jaw. Nice work, Deputy. Jacob's been using that place to turn... these wolves into judges for months now. Without it, one step closer to taking down his whole operation.
I've heard of you. Our scouts have found a plane at the Lansdowne airfield. Now all we need to do is slip past Jacob's patrols and go get it. What do you say? We could sure use the extra air support.
Lord! picked a fine fucking day to quit wrecking.
Aren't you the one that Eli rescued from the Grand View? Pretty sure I heard someone screaming over from Frank's place there. We should go and make sure he's okay.